Hello and welcome to Unit 5, where we're going to talk about all kinds of different costs, economic costs. Here, let's start distinguishing between explicit and implicit costs. Explicit costs are out-of-pocket or visible expenses. So if you're running a business, these are the things that you pull your checkbook out for and you actually make visible payments. For example, if you have to pay wages to workers, if you have to pay rent, if you have to buy office supplies or raw materials or any other ingredients to make your business run, you write a check to other people, and those are called explicit costs or explicit expenses. Implicit costs or implicit expenses are non-visible costs, sometimes also called opportunity costs. So these are not really out-of-pocket expenses, and you don't really see them. But in economics, we say that, for example, if you own your own building while you're running your business operation, there is not really any rent that you pay to anyone because you own the building. But if you had not run your business, you could have earned income, rent, by renting out the building. So there's an implicit or a sacrificed expense in this case. In accounting, the only expenses that the accountant takes into account to calculate, for example, the amount of taxes owed are the explicit costs. But in economics, because we deal with decision making, whether we should expand the business, whether we should continue to run the business, or whether we should shut down the business, we have to take both explicit and implicit costs into account. The sum of explicit and implicit costs is what we call total economic costs. So let's take a look at an example here that a typical business might face. So we have, first of all, wages to employees. So let's say that the business each month pays $6,000 in wages to employees. Second entry is office supplies. So each month the business might have an average of $400 in office supplies. Third one says rent foregone on a self-owned building. So this business operator owns the building, and the rent that this business person could have gotten on this building if he or she had not used it for his or her own business is, let's say, it's estimated at $1,000 per month. Now there's also the fourth one, interest foregone on self-owned funds. Let's say that the business person has invested $100,000 of his or her own money into the business, and perhaps that could have earned this person $700 each month in the bank if this person hadn't used the funds for his or her own business. Now there's also a loan that this business has taken out, and we've got to pay interest to the bank and perhaps some principal. But let's say the expenses on the loan each month are $500. And then the last expense is monthly equipment leasing expenses. So we have equipment, we have machines, and we have leased them, rented them in a way, and let's say that that costs $800. Now the question is, what are the explicit costs and what are the implicit costs? First of all, let's do the explicit costs. So the explicit costs, let's identify them. So these are visible out-of-pocket expenses. Well, first of all, wages to employees is an explicit cost. So that's $6,000. And then office supplies, another explicit cost. So I'm going to say $400. I'll leave out the dollar sign here. And then now rent foregone, that is not really an explicit cost. Interest foregone is also an implicit cost. Interest paid to the bank, that's an explicit cost. Comes directly out of the checkbook, out of the checking account. So that's $500. And then let's take a look at the monthly leasing expenses. Yes, that's another explicit cost. So another $800. We'll write that over here. And all that adds, if you add it all up, 6,000 plus 400, 6,400 plus 500, 6,900 plus 800 is 7,700. And let's squeeze that in here. 7,700 for total explicit cost. Now let's take a look at the implicit costs. Implicit costs are not out-of-pocket expenses. They are really sacrificed or foregone earnings. If we had not run this business, how much could we have earned? Well, rent foregone is certainly one. So if we hadn't used our own building, we could have earned $1,000 a month. Plus, the next one, interest foregone is also an implicit cost, so that's 700. And so the total implicit costs listed here add up to 1,700. Now, if you wanted to look at the total economic costs, which is the sum of explicit plus implicit costs, it would add up to 7,700 plus 1,700. By the way, sometimes in problems that we will have on the quiz, another implicit cost would be the value of the owner's time. And if that's specifically mentioned, then the value of the owner's time is also an implicit cost. Here it's not listed, so perhaps this owner of this business would be paying himself through a wage, perhaps a salary, so that would be included in this. But and it is an explicit cost if it's on, if he or she is on the payroll. So that's the sum of the total economic costs, explicit and implicit costs. Hope it makes sense.